It's another season of hard-hitting Quinnipiac ice hockey and red-hot basketball, side-by-side in one of college sports' most amazing venues for fans. Check the schedule and get your tickets at QuinnipiacBobcats.com.
The last day of 2011 brings with it Quinnipiac's final non-conference matchup of its season. The Bobcats will try to close out the year in style when they take on Boston University. Quinnipiac is seeking to eclipse its sixth adversary in its last seven contests. It's a New Year's Eve matinee, and it gets underway next. From the TD Bank Sports Center in Hamden, Connecticut, it's Quinnipiac University basketball. Today, the Bobcats take on the Terriers of Boston University. And good afternoon and Happy New Year, everybody. I'm Bill Schweitzer. My partner is Bill Mecca. Well, we have two teams that are headed in opposite directions right now. For Quinnipiac, they would like to keep this going into the new year, Billy. They've won five of their last six.
Well, and they've done it with defense and rebounding. That's been very, very good. On nights their offense has struggled, that defensive rebounding has been very good.
As far as Boston University, they are picked to repeat as the champions of the America East Conference. But right now, they have dropped their last five in a row.
Well, I think two things stand out there. The strength of schedule has been brutal, and DJ Irving, their second leading scorer, has been out with an injury.
All right, now, as far as the Bobcats are concerned, everybody wondered, how do you replace Justin Ruddy? Those are some big shoes to fill. Well, Ike Azatam has settled into those shoes very nicely.
He sure has. There's an old saying in basketball, it's not how big you are, it's how big you play. Listed at 6'5", wingspan is 7'2". His lift and his length have been a nightmare for opponents. Active around the glass, he's really, really good.
He is. He cleans up very well. As you can see, one of the leaders in the nation in rebounding and in offensive rebounding. Ike Azatam's numbers are right there. Now, for Boston University, how Darryl Parton goes, so go the Terriers, Billy.
Darryl Parton is an All-America East player. Early in the season, averaged 24 points a game, and now, due to Irving being out and teams focusing on him, his average has dropped, but still a guy, night in, night out, is going to get 18 shots and 20 points a game.
Now, you see it. He is averaging 20 points a game. He is among the top 20 scorers in the nation. And right now, we're going to bring in the third member of our team, Jamie Barker. Jamie?
Thank you, Bill. And Bill, and happy upcoming new year to the both of you. Now, it is a little bit sad for me because this is the last broadcast that I'm doing with you guys this season. And it's also sad for a couple Quinnipiac Bobcat players because, as you know, as the bright lights come on and these games are being played on television, the players really enjoy that. And they like the bigger audiences and they play better. Well, two of them in particular, senior guard, James Johnson and sophomore forward Ike Azatam are two of those guys who like the extra attention. As Johnson is averaging 20.7 points and 2.3 rebounds, and Azatam is averaging nearly 18 points and 13 rebounds during those games. You know, kind of like the two of you guys on television, you perform much better.
You know how it is, Jamie. When the lights are brightest, that's when the stars come out. So James Johnson and Ike Azatam, the guys to watch. Quinnipiac and Boston University, a New Year's Eve day matinee.
They've boxed us out harder down there than we have. And you haven't got one, you haven't got one. We haven't done what we're supposed to do yet offensively. Understand on that secondary screen now, you're going to have to, Ike or you, Keith, the trailing big. Dribble handoff coming off. He's running into it. You can't sit in here on that one. You got to show yourself. Ooh, somebody did it once really well. I did it really well. Active feet and then get back for a second. Go. The other big is going to have to play him if he rolls.
Be there for him now.
Let's go. Listening in on the Quinnipiac huddle, Tom Moore. Doing the X's and O's and doing a little coaching there.
Well, Ang did a good job in the huddle. He talked about two things we talked about in the pregame. He talked a lot about offensive rebounding, what Quinnipiac hasn't done, what they're supposed to do, and then the defensive end. And offensively, they've been a little shaky. Real good huddle that time by Moore and his staff.
Hi, my name is Evan Conti from Queens, New York, and my New Year's resolution is just to be a better citizen in the community, be a better teammate, a better son, and just improve in my academics and basketball and everything else in life daily.
Hi, my name is Zaid Hurst. I'm a freshman from Silver Spring, Maryland, and my New Year's resolution is to be more happy, have a smile, and get Coach Burrell some more hair.
Okay. Hi, I'm Terrence Bob Jones. My New Year's resolution is to stay true to myself and become a better student in school.
Hi, I'm Nate Goes, and my New Year's resolution is to be a better student athlete and to do more for my family when it's needed.
Pretty good resolutions there, Mr. Mecca.
I like them all. You got any, partner?
I was wondering about getting more hair for Coach Burrell.
Well, I think it's a lot like me. I'm not saying we're bald. I think we just choose not to have hair.
I got you.
So it's a personal choice there, partner.
I got you. Mike Azatam back in for the Bobcats. Two-point BU lead. The Terriers of Boston University, they shot out to a five-point lead, and they have been out in front ever since. Let's bring in the third member of our team, Jamie Parker, standing by. Jamie?
Thank you very much, Bill. Well, the Bobcats have had to make some adjustments without Jamie Jackson in the lineup. He is sitting on the bench with a boot on his left foot. He's out for about 3 to 4 weeks with a sprained ankle he suffered in the shoot-around before Niagara. So without Jamie Jackson there, he has had two 20-point games in the last five games. He's also a very big compliment to Ike at 6'7", one of the only two big guys on the team. So, guys, you're going to have to watch out for your opponents taking advantage of Jamie Jackson not in the lineup.
All right, thanks, Jamie. Let me see Jamie Jackson. Few of the Bobcats in street clothes today.
You know, Billy, Quinnipiac's been able to go ahead and play without Jamie Jackson because over the course of the last four games, Azatam's been special. Azatam today has just been average with only 2 points.
There is Ike up with the floater and doesn't hit it.
Yeah, good heady play by Griffin in transition.
Griffin, another guy that is a transfer to BU, played a couple of years at Rider down in New Jersey.
Yeah, Billy, you talk about all those transfers. You got kids in this program at BU on a real good move down there. Community.
Hi, I'm Usman Dryman from the Quinnipiac men's basketball team, and my New Year's resolution is to rise above all little things.
Hi, my name's Kevin Tarka, and my New Year's resolution is to spend less time with technology and more time with family and friends.
Hi, my name is Dave Johnson, and my New Year's resolution is to do everything better than I did in 2011.
Hi, my name is Alex Jackson, and my New Year's resolution is to get more money in 2012 and for the Bobcats to get a win tonight against BU.
Okay.
Financially secured. Davey Johnson wants to do things better. Well, he shouldn't have had that technical foul. You saw Coach Moore talking to him a little bit during that break, partner.
Yeah, we will not see him for the rest of this half, that's for sure. Four fouls on him. Griffin gets it down low. This is Morris backing in on Azatam. That's a pretty good battle. All right, Bobcats trailing the Terriers, the Dogs, out in front of the Cats by 13 points at halftime. So what do you do if you're Quinnipiac? Well, we took a little peek into their locker room and eavesdropped on Tom Moore's halftime talk to the Bobcats.
They're trying to not allow you to post up. They're boxing you out physically. They are playing very hard because they feel good about their defense. When we run our offense, if we let them dictate at any spot on the ball, when you're trying to pop to get open, if we let them dictate and they're jumping in front of you and in the passing lane, if we can't post up, if we can't set a solid screen, if we can't set our screen and we're letting them dictate where we set our screens, we're not gonna have any success in the second half. So own this area in the paint a little bit more. Believe in our screens, believe in the spot you're supposed to be in, do it with some conviction when they're on you. Offensive rebounding is not gonna be just, let me go, no one's gonna box me out, straight line to the glass. They're doing a great job boxing out. When you get boxed, you're going to spin this way, spin that way, and stay relentless. We have 5 offensive rebounds right now. Worst we've had in a half in probably the whole season. Because they're boxing us, and we're stopping. They box us, we got to spin either way. You got to spin either way and stay relentless, okay? Defensive is going to win the game, all right? They shot 44. We shot
30. All right, Bobcats, more telling them they got to believe. What's assistant coach Sean Daugherty have to say? He's with Jamie Parker.
Thank you very much, guys. That was a tough first half. Not only were they getting all these points in the paint, but also four fouls on Dave. Talk about that.
Yeah, I mean, that was tough on Dave. Dave lost his cool for a second there, and, you know, we need him in the game to facilitate the basketball, and that really hurt us. But, you know, we have other guys have to step up in second half and be a little bit more physical, and they played real physical in the first half, and we just got to match that right now in the second half.
Also, without Jamie Jackson, it seems like they're double-teaming Ike, and that's got to be an issue as well.
Yeah, Ike's going to start getting double teams. I mean, he's putting up great numbers, and he's got to start getting used to that. And, he's got to be able to pass it out, then repost, and hopefully our guards will start making some shots in the second half, and we'll make some of those bunnies that we were missing.
All right, good luck in the second half,
Thank
Sean.
You.
All right, back to you guys.
All right, thanks, Jamie. Two teams get set to strut it out here for the second half. There are the stats.
Hi, my name is Marquise Barnett, and my New Year's resolution is to win the NEC Conference.
Hi, my name is Jamie Jackson, and my New Year's resolution is to not rely on my phone so much. Every time, like every minute, I'm looking at my phone, and I want to do less of that for 2012.
Hi, my name is Garvey Young, and my New Year's resolution is to stay happy and stay healthy, also to finish this year very strong academically.
Hi, my name is Ike Azatum, and my New Year's resolution is to get Dean's List, all A's and B's for the second semester of school.
Some very heady resolutions there. Dean's List, academic excellence.
I like the technology and the phone thing, you know? You listen to this thing out there, you got all these smartphones.
The Bobcats have outscored BU 17-6 to start the second half, and they pulled within 2 points. Quinnipiac women's team off to a terrific start. They've won 9 of their first 12 games. Jamie Parker is standing by with one of the women, Jacinda Dunbar. Jamie?
Thank you very much, Bill. That's right. The women are here cheering on the men. There's a lot of cross support going on here at Quinnipiac. And Jacinda, their team has a lot to be proud of. You guys are 9-3, first in NEC scoring, first in rebounding. Talk about what the season you've had so far.
The season has been one of the best that I've had since being here. We have a lot of girls that are on the same page for the first time in 4 years, and it shows in our record. You know, we're all hungry to win. We hate losing, and so we pride ourselves on our defense. If our shots aren't falling, then we know we're really good on defense, and we'll keep them from scoring as well.
And it's nice that you can always get the ball back when Felicia's stealing everything in sight.
Oh, yeah. We always have something on the bench. I'm telling Fee to get her rebounds up, get her steals up. You know, she always, before every game, it's always, I'm about to get 5 rebounds, 5 steals, everything. So,
well, good luck in 2012, Jacinda. We know everybody will be watching.
Thank you.
All right. Thanks. Back to you guys.
Thanks, Jamie. Bobcats looking to try and get even here.
Hi, my name is Isaiah Woodsmith, and my New Year's resolution is to get a 4.0 GPA.
Hi, my name is Justin Harris, and my New Year's resolution is to get out of these street clothes and back into a uniform to play basketball once again.
Hi, my name is James Johnson, and my New Year's resolution is probably just for the team, just keep getting better to go out on top my senior year.
All right, Bobcats, resolutions for New Year's. Everybody making them today, breaking them tomorrow.
Or the day after. One or the other.
Yeah, just reeled up. And he is 5 for 5 from the line so far. 6 for 6. 16 for James Johnson. 5 seconds left. This is Griffin. Blocked by Drame. And that will do it. So, the Bobcats win it 59-53. Join us for our next Quinnipiac telecast Friday, February 3rd at 7 p.m. Bobcats hockey against Harvard. For Jamie Parker, Bill Schweitzer, our entire crew, good night. Happy New Year, everybody.
You're watching NESN. We now join our regularly scheduled programming already in